Ladies and gentlemen, there is your host, Tom Corless.
Thank you, Russ. Tonight, Magic Band Plus was released earlier this week by accident. So depending what state we're in, we may have to keep them. A Texas lawmaker is looking to remove no-fly zones over Disney's theme parks in Florida and California. So is that religious skywriting guy. Jeff Morrell is exiting the Walt Disney Company less than 4 months after taking over as chief communications officer. Maybe he had a lightning lane. Personally, I would have chose gunner or engineer. Those seem a little easier. You've read WDW News Today. Now it's time for WDW News Tonight.
It's just great balls of fire. Kisses the baby. Feels good. Hold me, baby. Well, I want to love you like I love a should. You're fine. So kind. Got to tell this world that you're mine. Got you my nails on and I twiddle my thumb. I'm real nervous, but it sure is fun. Come on, baby. It drives me crazy. It's just great balls of fire.
Nick's here somewhere. Nick's around. We'll get a camera over there. It's fine. We got to show off our stylish shirts, Nick.
I know.
We have stylish
I love
shirts.
It.
But in the meantime, hello, I'm Tom Corless. And where I grew up, we had drive-bys, not drive-ins. True story. Had a bullet whiz by my face once. Super fun. Please hit the like button, subscribe, and if you're really enjoying this nonsense, you can leave a super chat here on YouTube. Your donations will be used to replace all the speakers people forgot to remove from their car windows before they drove off. Nick, how's it going?
Good, good. Were you saying that like Disney security was after you up even in New York? Or?
I said bullets, not what? I don't even know what they use. No, they have like batons. A taser? Someone said taser. Someone had experience. You're like, that time we fought over mugs on the 50th, I was tasered. Right to the ground. They're like, no iridescent Starbucks mug for you. There's no fake babies here, though. We don't have the fake. No fake baby. I wish we had the fake babies. That would be tremendous. Yeah. Anyway. Now the news.
News.
Brought to you by the WDWNT Inner Globe Society. Actually, I forgot before we get to the news, actually. We don't have a camera on you. We're working on it.
Sure.
But we are wearing these stylish shirts. And the cool thing about these Sci-Fi Dine-In button-down shirt, Tom Corless shirts, as they've been called before, is you can own one, too. Mm-hmm. They're actually available from Carousel Products right now at carouselproducts.com. So go pick one up. It's the first one we've done. I'm very excited. Finally, shirts I can wear that people will see, not the shirt under here.
Love it.
Oh, we almost had Nick for a second. Goodness gracious. There we go. He's out in the hallway of the restaurant. Put him out there. Yeah. There you go. Look at these shirts. We're like twins.
Wow. This is great.
Now Disney security could easily spot us so they can taser us. They're all wearing the same shirt. We accidentally tased the people that work at Sci-Fi. We got them. There's a lot of them. Oh, boy. why is my food cold? Well, your server was tased. As soon as they woke up from it, they brought the food. According to Disney, Jeff Morrell is leaving the company to pursue other opportunities. There have been several public relations issues in the past few months, mainly regarding CEO Bob Chapek's delayed response to the Florida Don't Say Gay bill. Morrell is also infamous for accidentally leaking the opening date of Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind. But I don't know, I leaked like 30 opening dates and I'm still here, so I don't know. don't know. What does it say when you last shorter at Disney PR than at BP or the Pentagon?
Nah.
It's as if Disney PR's department is a dumpster fire. I've never heard that before, though. I've only heard positive things. Someone just yelling scrupulous? Get back to work in the popcorn machine, Pete. Look at that. We have a concession stand tonight, by the way. Everyone in attendance got concessions here. Look at this. We got Twizzlers. Not Red Vines. This ain't Disneyland. We ain't serving Red Vines. We got the real thing. We got Twizzlers here. Popcorn. Reese's Pieces. We got the... You don't have to be a kid like at Boathouse to get the cardboard car tonight. Yeah. It's great. Great. Oh, some loose popcorn. All right. That's still terrible. Ooh. Are we not seasoning that at all?
Yeah.
Man, suddenly Disney theme park popcorn seems a lot better. Suddenly, I'm going to have to change all those reviews. Anyway, Mr. Morrell was outspoken about a need to modernize Disney's approach to communications, even though his predecessor and spawn of Satan, Xenia Mucha, ran what was widely considered a best-in-class operation. That, of course, being, if you consider best-in-class, arguing with Scarlett Johansson and fan blogs. If you consider those to be best-in-class practices, then yeah, she's your lady. Morrell should have known he wouldn't last at Disney PR when he said they should be more honest with the public.
Nah.
That was probably the moment when everyone that sat in the meeting was like, "Should we? Are we gonna tell him? He'll be gone soon." Boy. Disney released new concept art for the reimagining of Epcot, announcing we will be getting a giant Epcot symbol, lights in the ground, a character meet and greet facility, and a building. For those keeping score at home, they demolished a giant Epcot symbol, lights in the ground, a character meet and greet, and a building. It's not so much better, though, now. So much better. The new building is mostly the same shape as the one they knocked down, but this one won't be the Edison. They do this a lot now, this knock down a building and rebuild the same shape thing. Yeah. These structures will be named Communicore Hall and Communicore Plaza, while the Moana Journey of Water will now be called Communicore Plumbing. It's all connected. The Communicore Hall will feature a demo kitchen, a mixology bar, a gallery space, and more, so it'll have all the features already present here at WDWNT Celebration. Try to keep up, boys. Try to keep up. We're going to have a projection coaster, too. Nick's going to spin you in an office chair while I play the Guardians of the Galaxy movies. It's great. Whoa! Bob Chapek, an Indiana University alumnus, will be speaking at IU's commencement. Don't you dare. He will be speaking at IU's commencement on Saturday. During the ceremony, the university will also award Chapek with an honorary Doctor of Humane Letters degree. Yeah, specifically the letters F and U. No, that's childish. Guys, they symbolize the career advice he's going to be giving in his speech. Fail upwards. So then I don't know, I was there. And he's like, "You're CEO." I was like, "All right." Then the world closed. I don't know. It turns out Star-Lord will make several references to classic Epcot attractions during a pre-show video for Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind, saying that he can't wait to see Horizons, the Universe of Energy Dinosaurs, and Kitchen Cabaret. God, this guy lost his mother, his girlfriend, Horizons. This poor man. This poor man. No one tell him, please. Of course, he loved Kitchen Cabaret. His favorite song was in that Veggie Veggie Groot Groot. Does it even have sound tonight? I don't know what's going on. I didn't hear it. I don't know. Oh, boy. I don't know. I don't like this video. I haven't been pandered to this hard since Disney let me back on the media list for 5 minutes in 2017. Oh, we love your stuff. It's great. I read it all the time. Yeah, because you're forced to. When it's put across your desk by someone complaining about it. The menu for Tony's Town Square restaurant, The Magic Kingdom, has been updated with some items removed, notably pizza, is no longer listed, likely due to supply chain issues at Totino's. There's a big pepperoni shortage. Oh, man. According to Japan's Prime Minister Fumio Kishida, did I say that right?
Oh, my God.
What is it?
Fumio Kishida.
Fumio Kishida.
Wow.
The nation is preparing. The nation is preparing to ease border restrictions this June. This means that international tourists will once again be able to travel to Tokyo Disney Resort and Universal Studios Japan. Oh, June. It's not. It's May, right? It's May. What? Not yet. Not yet. Before we came on tonight, Eric Morton comes up to me and he goes, you're going to go to Japan for a month, aren't you? It's like, maybe. He's like, you're going to leave me with all these people. You're going to leave me with all these people.
Wait, no, don't feel bad for Eric.
We're on the air here. You can't talk while we're on the air. Come on. Come on. Disney, I'm mic'd and on the show. Never have children, please. Disney settled a six-figure lawsuit with a guest who contracted bed bugs at the Disneyland Hotel. Meanwhile, a large colony of bed bugs is suing the All-Star Resorts for a people infestation. Yeah. They contracted the bed bugs. That's just to finish the DVC tower, actually. I think it was cheaper labor there. Oh, what?
So, you've shown up late to meet your friends for dinner. I said, you've shown up late to meet your friends for dinner. Yes, I'm talking to you. You're late meeting your friends for dinner.
I mean, it wasn't actually my fault. Like, Rise went down, and I was already in the middle of the line. You don't give that up. So, like, they already know that I'm going to be late, and it's fine. Like, they just said, hey, text us when you're here.
Oh, no. One must never interrupt a meal with frivolous noise from a cell phone.
Oh. Then, like, how should I get a hold of them? Like, should I, like, go and talk to a hostess or something?
Oh, no. You should never bother a busy worker with a problem you've created.
I mean, I don't think they're mine. They're just kind of standing there.
Oh, one also mustn't be presumptuous about how busy someone is or isn't.
I mean, that's probably a really good point. But, like, how do I let them know that I'm here then?
Well, it's time to pick up your things and head inside to find your friends on this journey of a lifetime.
Okay, I mean, that seems a little overdramatic. I mean, they're probably just, like, right in through the door.
Too late. Your journey has already begun, so stand back and keep those hands and feet clear of the doors. Por favor, manténgase alejado de las puertas. Please stand clear of the doors. As you begin your journey, one should begin combing the restaurant landscape like combing the desert for an oasis.
Yeah, this is not what I was... This looks completely different from the outside. Why is there a comb in my hand?
As you begin your trek across this barren wasteland in search of your dinner companions...
Oh, it's so bright, too! I mean, like, I thought I was supposed to be in a drive-in movie!
What?
Oh, this is... Oh, God, it's so hot! It was supposed to be an air conditioning.
Keep wits about them and remain cool, calm, and collected.
Seriously?
While on your journey of a lifetime. Time.
What is going on around here?
It may feel like an uphill battle. Just remember, there ain't no mountain high enough that can stop
this,
you.
This is ridiculous. Life is
like climbing a mountain. Hard to climb, but once you get to the top, the view is beautiful.
I don't want a beautiful view. I just want a burger with friends. Ugh. Okay, you know what? You know you're damn lucky I carry a light jacket in this bag. Ugh. Seriously, this is ridiculous. I don't think you even know what a simile is.
There really is no pleasing you. Happiness, like water, is always available. So often it seems...
Oh, come on!
This program is brought to you by WIGS, the WDWNT Interglobe Society. Support WDWNT to get early and exclusive access to content you can't find anywhere else, including exclusive post shows for WDW News Tonight and Park Center, exclusive programs including our retro-riffing show, Ride Rehab Watches, bonus episodes of Club 22, and a monthly Zoom with Tom. access to our Discord community, and much more, starting at just $2 a month. For more information, visit patreon.com/WDWNT or visit WDWNT.com and click the Patreon link. Join Wigs and unlock even more WDWNT.
Dumbest show. We have, in fairness, we have a great show for you tonight. There's a lot to come, Nick. We got a lot, right?
We got a lot. Yeah.
Who wants to win a lot of Corbucks? You'll be hosting this evening?
Yes, I will.
We do. We have
Liquid Magic.
Liquid Magic, you'll also be a part of. Oh! We got Cornac the Magnificent going to be visiting this evening as well. We're going to revisit your favorite movies if. The headline, they were headlines written by Inside the Magic or the Disney Food Blog. So we had a lot coming your way. Stick around for more after this intermission.
Over there.
Over where?
Over there.
Over here?
No, over there.
Over there!
The warehouse is in danger, the goodies we must save. All officers report at once, the situation's grave. Go get them, boys, for this sake. The culprits must be stopped. We'll make the scene with our siren, Arizona pop as pop. Aha! The guilty ones are trapped, we've now performed our mission. But the climax isn't kept until we have an intermission.
She's a girl who loved a man. A man who, in a flash, became a living threat to humanity. A danger so awe-inspiring that they tried to hide his existence from the world.
What happened? What made him grow?
Bob Chapek is being promoted at an alarming rate. Now he's in charge of home video, the next day consumer products, the next day parks and resorts, then CEO maybe.
But you've got to stop it.
I don't want to speak in public anymore.
Day and night, scientists search, trying every experiment their brilliant minds can conceive. Finding the expected, the unexpected, and the shocking. For the immeasurable power of this ever-growing mammoth portends a fate that terrifies the universe.
Drive it in hard. We have to penetrate the bone in the first ejection. Ready?
Look out, it's reaching down!
We want to help you to get well.
Manning's disappeared, Eric. We can't find him anywhere on the grounds.
The public does not like this man. This is not a news flash.
A man once loved by a woman, now feared by the whole world.
A 60-foot giant in the streets of Las Vegas.
Say, did you see the skid marks out here? They go at a direct right angle to the direction of travel.
No digs in the macadam either. Somebody was hurt. There's blood all over this thing.
What is this black menace that kills everything it sees and hears? No human mind could imagine the enormous destructive power of this maddened, killing thing. if you're young people in love. Look out. If you're driving a lonely road, you're as good as dead. There's been a lot of livestock missing lately. That doesn't make headlines, but now it's people. Never in the history of the United States, a monster of such size and power and horrifying hatred of man.
You all right, Ning?
Yeah, I just have a little sore. A little woozy.
Let me see that. You got something on your head.
What?
Let me.
Oh, whoa. Hey.
It was the worst $8 I've ever spent.
Oh, you spent worse.
This cup says otherwise. Oh, boy. What's happening? Where am I? I'm over here. What's happening this week on Disney Plus? Tune in for the blogger that hated people. They step on you, walk on you, and kick you. So... Sci-Fi, yeah. Live-In special. We're celebrating sci-fi, not only the Sci-Fi Dine-In Theater, but also sci-fi movies, our favorite sci-fi movies. So we thought it would be fun. I think there's been a lot of scrutiny out there for some what people call clickbait titles that some blogs run, namely Inside the Magic and Disney Food Blogs. We thought it'd be fun to revisit some of our favorite science fiction movies if they were headlines written by these two blogs. Does everyone want to see what they would be? Is everyone? Okay. All right. Let's see what we got. Local restaurant terrorized by gigantic woman on Inside the Magic. That's someone's tweet that was taken, probably. You won't believe who Luke Skywalker. You won't believe who Luke Skywalker's dad is. Not him. That would be weird. The weather was hot. The weather was hot on Alderaan yesterday. Woo. Warm. We found this incredible cupcake on Tatooine. I don't know. That seems like there's something else going on in that photo. I don't know if the cupcake's the story, really. I guess we're going to ignore that, all right. Disney takes an illegal alien as refugee, claims Magic Kingdom as sanctuary. Hill Valley Man. Hill Valley man cheats on girlfriend with his own mother. You won't believe her reaction. Top 10 places to eat. Oh, man. Top 10 places to eat when you enter the Matrix. We love green Mickey waffles. I love them. Neo waffles. Sci-Fi Dine-In lights were out, but service still continued in the dark. That never happens. Finally, after 8 attempts, 9th plan from this planet will move forward. Find out when here. Oh boy. Could this Sith Lord be related to abandoned child near Mos Eisley theme park? It's the incredible Bantha in the background. Mm-hmm. What tragedy won't the Jedi tell you? I can't anymore. We are a... We are obsessed with this new super weapon. I think today they had the media preview. They were like, guys, it's just depressing people, but it's super fun. We loved it. Are there more of these? Great. You won't believe why this father refuses to see his son on Tatooine. Hint, it's rough, coarse, and gets everywhere. What to do if you get sick on the Death Star? Oh, man. Wow. All right. Well, send your hate mail, if you work for either of those organizations, to tom@wdwnt.com. I'll promptly delete it. What is that?
I don't know.
Oh, my God! It's the attack of the formerly 5-foot-tall woman!
You make fun of my height?
She's so mean!
I told you!
I'm not mean!
You're mean! You put a hole in my rotunda! There was a beautiful stained glass piece up there, and you smashed it! Something's gonna happen.
Oh no! An airplane ran into her eyes!
Oh, it must have been because legislators removed the no-fly zone above Disney World, so it was able to go right over and into her eye. That plane came down. I don't think anyone was hurt though.
Oh gosh. My plane just got hit by some giant 50-foot-tall woman.
Spencer? Are you all right?
I could be...
Not you! My bag of stuff from Japan! Is it all right? Are you okay?
Thanks. Thank you, Tom.
Man. Woody's all right. Oh! The giant woman dented my Choco Crunch tin! What am I supposed to do with this now?
Tom's going to be preoccupied with this merchandise for a while.
It's dented from her head!
It's her giant head! It's time to take an intermission.
I can't buff this out.
Yum, yum. It's time for a tasty and refreshing snack. To satisfy your hunger, your thirst, your sweet tooth. So visit our refreshment center now. Let's go!
Calling all boys, calling all girls, the countdown has started, and you are wanted at the launching pad.
for the blast-off of our giant satellite space show into the amazing adventure crammed with thrills, jammed with action, showing you wonders never before seen in outer space. Plus, you'll receive absolutely free a genuine souvenir ticket on the first spaceship to Mars. So come on, you Astro boys. Come on, you Astro girls. Suit up for the ride of your life at our satellite space show. You'll be astounded at what you see because you are there.
What's this all about? What's everybody running from?
It's the end of everything.
What do you mean?
I'm not arguing theory, General. I'm here to ask you, to beg you, to save your own world.
It, the most fascinating mastermind man can conceive. A monster that can control all sources of the Earth's power. Able to pull man-made spaceships from their orbits. Making of those it chooses, slaves. Of this woman, a willing handmaiden. Of the chief of police, a cold-blooded killer.
I've known you for 5 years. You just killed a man in cold blood. Why?
I'll have to place you under protective custody.
Peter Graves, the scientist who fought it. Beverly Garland, who believed her love stronger than it. Lee Van Cleef, whose brilliant mind was captured by it.
Are you really ready to stop loving me?
I'll need you even when no emotion exists.
For a few dollars, you can hire a woman who'll fit all your fetishes. She'll match your requirements perfectly. Then if you ever get tired of it, you can always run down to the employment agency for another.
You'll know terror to freeze your blood. You'll feel the heart-stopping strength of the most fearful monster ever known.
You think you're gonna make a slave of the world? I'll see you in hell first.
It conquered the world.
May I help you?
I'd like two of those, please.
Hot dogs? Yes, sir.
And three of those. And one of those. And five bars of these. And a cup of a nice hot liquid.
Coffee. Coming right up.
Oh, and two bags of those peculiar white puffy material.
You mean our crunchy popcorn. Shall I wrap that for you, sir?
Oh, that's all right. My saucer's just outside.
They come from miles to enjoy our intermission.
Welcome back to Me in the Empty Chair. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hitting the like button. Thanks for subscribing. And thank you especially to our WIGS members who are watching tonight and our WIGS members here tonight. Where are WIGS members at? There we go. Let's see what you can pick up this week at our concession stand.
Yum, yum. It's time for a tasty and refreshing snack.
So we pick up the... Pick up a box of Mike and Eisner's original idea flavor.
We Hello, promise Mike and to Eisner's. Satisfy your hunger, your thirst, your sweet tooth. So visit our refreshment center now. Let's go.
We're going to go to the refreshment center right now, actually, because it's time for some liquid magic. Oh!
We're back, baby!
Yeah!
Let me start off by saying, happy Cinco de Mayo, or Feliz 5 of May. So, listen, right? We have a theme tonight.
Yes,
you want to tell everyone about our theme? Well, our theme is, guess what? It's Sci-Fi Diner, yeah.
That's right.
We have some cocktails off of their menu.
That are out of this world.
Oh, yeah. And we have four of them. Four special cocktails.
All right, so why don't I kick things off? Because it is Cinco de Mayo.
Two for you, two for me.
Two for you, two for me.
We share.
What we're going to do is we have a lot of sci-fi fun drinks, but it's also Cinco de Mayo, as I mentioned. So we got to do a margarita. We are doing the Spicy Martian Margarita. This is sold on property over at Cosmics, right? I think so.
Sci-fi?
Did I just say Cosmics?
What
sci-fi?
Is Cosmics?
Guys, it
like
is.
Cosmic
remember race? The theme.
It is almost Seis de Mayo.
Look at the theme.
How
Look
much did
the
you
theme.
Drink today, Pete?
Not that much for
Cosmic
a single
rays?
De Mayo. All right, here we go. Put some tequila
it's
in
your liquid magic.
To kill a small child. All right,
Nick takes offense to that joke.
No, but listen, you want mostly tequila in this because everything else is going to be a little potent, a little strong, and that's real talk.
Have you tried
this
that
is
stuff?
The, yeah, this is this is why I'm glad I'm making this. I don't like things too spicy, so I'm going to do very little of this. That's why we did more of this. But if you're a spicy person,
spicy.
Then you might like this. This is the chili ancho liqueur, we're just gonna do a little.
It's liquid magic.
How's your father? I gotta go.
It's liquid magic.
Then we're gonna add a little bit of simple syrup. We're using. You can find simple syrup in any grocery store. Mm-hmm. You can make your own. It's basically a little sugar water.
It's liquid magic.
I would do equal parts your spice and your simple syrup.
Yep.
And last but not least, we're gonna use some lime. Cutting limes here tonight in the sci-fi world is rough, so here's some lime juice, and you just want to put a little
it's
bit in.
Liquid magic.
Six limes.
No, that's about a lime and a half, believe me. Lime and a half if you're at home. Now, the fun part, let's shake.
Shake, Sinora, shake your body liner. Shake, Sinora, shake it all the time.
I hope that's playing for everyone and not just
Sinora,
us here.
Work your body liner.
Here it in my hand.
Here we go.
Sinora,
there we go.
Look at that. Let's move this to the back. Here we go.
All right.
The magic.
Let's see it.
I didn't show the glass. I apologize.
It's liquid magic.
There you go.
It's liquid magic.
You ready for this bad boy?
I am.
It's liquid magic.
Oh, baby. Oh. Oh.
It's liquid magic.
Yeah, I told you, Tom. He can make the margarita a lot better than I can.
Is it actually
Tommy boy?
That's good.
That's a great margarita.
You guys drank out of this glass, right?
Yeah, but we made out 10 minutes ago.
It's liquid magic.
Oh boy.
It's pretty good.
Oh, thank you.
That is really good.
All right, Nick, what do we have next?
I'm going to take you on an odyssey. A green space odyssey. Yes, I am. All right, let's see what we got here. We need the... I just had the rum. There you are, Captain. There you are. You were hiding from me. All right. We're going to take a little little rum here.
You're talking to the captain.
What? Come
it's
on.
Liquid magic.
The captain, we go way back. I measure. I know. Look, I'm a measurer. What can I say?
Always add a little extra because it ends up on the mat.
He doesn't like to measure. Where's that? We don't want orange juice. Where's my pineapple juice?
Pineapple right there.
There you are. Hello, Mr. Pineapple.
You're my
Get in my
pineapple.
Mixer. All right. Gonna do some pineapple
it's liquid juice.
Magic. Look at that. Look at that. Over the mixer. So if you spill.
Right.
I mean, I'm tired of licking the table after.
Yeah, it happens. He's not tired of licking anything. Little blue eye carrot.
Blue Curacao.
Thank you. You got me.
It's liquid magic.
Me. Oop, too much.
That is not good.
It's liquid magic.
That's amazing. Of all the things, he's like, blue Curacao.
All right.
Here we go. Shake,
Sinora, shake your body liner. Shake, Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, Sinora, work your body liner. Work,
see that? Watch this. Watch that.
I bet just gonna be.
It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic.
I don't care how it reads. That looks
green
good.
Name?
All
right.
We're going on a blue space. Much deeper than we thought in space. You gotta go past green.
Once it hits the atmosphere, it'll turn green.
Yeah. I mean, that's how it works.
You wanna try first? I'll let you do the honors. Take a big old gulp.
It's liquid magic.
I gotta tell you, I've had better.
It's liquid magic.
This is a great drink for your in-laws.
Take a syringe of that.
Hey, get your syringe in there.
By the way, we're supposed to do this.
Oh, yeah.
Look how green that is. I jumped way too much.
It's liquid magic.
Go. Don't waste your syringe.
In fairness, it does taste like a cocktail from space to
there we go. There we go. Magic. Whoa. It's green.
Well, now this is no good.
Yellow and blue make green. I learned that in math.
It's liquid magic.
How many times have you said that?
That's what we used to always say growing up in our house.
There you go. That's it.
Not gonna finish itself.
That's it. Whoa.
Spencer, I'm worried.
Got that? Do you want the other?
Coming out of everywhere.
You need the pretty
Spencer's
one
Spencer's not
on
old
there.
Enough. Don't give him
the pretty one on there.
I checked his ID actually before the show, and that is not a lie.
I don't care what Japan says.
Look at that greenness.
Well, Oklahoma says he's old enough, which I don't know what Oklahoma license looks like. So it could have been fine. It said Walmart on the side.
I mean, Oklahoma could be a fake place. You never know.
That's okay.
I've never been there. I don't know.
Okay by me. Yeah.
All right. Let's get on to the next drink. So we're staying in space. The Long Island Lunar Tea.
Lunar Tea.
Sometimes it's necessary to take a moment along the journey of a lifetime.
Time.
What? And take a moment.
She with
no,
you?
No, please take the blue one, green one.
Use a syringe.
That's liquid magic.
Oh, no.
Give her a syringe.
It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic.
Wow.
Sometimes it's necessary to take a moment and contemplate your life choices.
It's liquid magic.
Wow. Pretty crazy stuff. Did I mention that was my designated driver?
The bad time to mention, we still don't have health insurance.
So, yikes. Kay. All right, do we have another shaker? We have another shaker, right?
Yeah, we do. Yes.
All right, so the Long Island Lunar Tea, I thought it would be appropriate. I just got back from Long Island. I was there last weekend. And then we had to do some crazy drinks. And what better than the Long Island Lunar Tea? So this is going to be some fun. You're going to get a little bit of everything.
What's in there, man?
All right, Coley, get the kitchen sink, right? Do we have any bottles bigger than this? This is perfect. All right. Basically, you want to do your, there's four liquors in this. You want to do them all pretty equal. So, like, hey, how are you?
It's liquid magic.
That's
you
the vodka.
Like, do you like white
then
rum?
Tequila? A little.
A little tequila?
Hey, how are you?
It's liquid magic.
Then we need some rum. Rum
is that? Is that, do you want white rum or dark rum?
White rum. You want white rum.
Okay.
Yes. And then a little, hey, how
it's
are you
liquid
doing?
Magic.
Hold on. This is going to be fun. Gin. Oh, Tanqueray? Gross. Find any gin better than Tanqueray. What the heck are we doing here, WDWNT?
Who do you think
bought that? It's liquid magic.
I'm doing more shopping after this.
You two stocked the bar.
What's he got there?
All right, we're looking for some Cointreau.
Right there.
Yep, just gonna add a little something-something.
A little something-something.
It's liquid magic.
Sweet and sour. I know I got it around somewhere.
You got the simple syrup, you got the lemon, you got the lime. You're gonna have to make
yourself. Oh, we're gonna do our own.
Yeah, you're gonna do your own sweet and sour.
To be honest, I like this a little better, or you can use even agave.
He thinks I was gonna do this for
him. This is totally gonna do the trick.
Look at that.
Hey, we're from Long Island.
Sweet and sour. Magic.
And then I don't like this part, but we're gonna do it because it calls for it. Is we use a splash.
No. Don't you do that after you shake?
Yeah, I'm just letting everyone know.
Oh, okay. Because last time there was a time when Pete threw that in there
that
with the bubbly.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Shook it and they went,
where? I've been saying this so many times throughout my life, but where's my top?
Oh,
there he is. Here we go.
Shake, 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 Sinora, shake your body liner. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sinora, work your body liner. Work, work.
All right.
I'm so glad that table's as high as it is.
Oh, yeah, go for it. Hello.
You got some ice over here. Sorry, I'm just going
to
barrel.
Nice to meet you.
Hi. All right, let's do it.
Put it in there. Pour it out.
It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic.
Wow. Look at that. Slash it. Should you say you don't like the splash of Coke?
It's liquid magic.
I personally don't. I'd rather use something like... It's liquid magic. I mean, it's not going to taste like a Long Island, but personally, I like something like a cream soda or a root beer or something like that.
Oh, love it, yeah.
But a lot of people like Coke.
Except love it.
Some people like Diet Coke, no ice. I don't know. Here we go. Your Long Island Lunar Tea.
Yes.
It's liquid magic.
Ooh, takes me right back to college.
It sure does.
It's liquid magic.
You go to college at the Sci-Fi Dine-In?
I mean, that's a lot of stuff in there.
All right, hold on, before he...
It is lunar.
I'll give you a splash there for your
syringe. Go for it, Tom.
Should I get to the bottom?
Wherever you want.
Oh, no, oh.
Oh, wow, that's...
Way too aggressive.
What?
Way too aggressive.
She just drank that whole other content.
She did.
Yeah, but she didn't go, like, dive in head first, like she was bobbing for apples.
All right,
go ahead.
It's liquid magic.
That's pretty good.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. That's a pretty good from Tom Twice, so please remember this date.
That's about as good as my reviews get. That's
what
Guardians is going to
get. Can I get a banner? Pete got two pretty goods out of two pretty goods.
It's decent.
All right. Let's finish it off with a banger, though, Nick. What do we got?
All right.
People have had their meal. They're ready.
Yeah. So this is a request. Tom said if we're going to do a liquid magic with sci-fi, it's going to have to include the Orbiting Oreos milkshake, right?
Yeah! So we said, boring. Go to Carvel.
It's cookies and...
They have alcoholic milkshakes at Carvel?
That's right.
It's cookies and cream ice cream and Godiva chocolate liqueur.
So go ahead, go home and make it. But this is liquid... Friggin' magic!
It's liquid magic.
Magic.
We just threw the top to an ice cream container.
All right. Give me the blender. You. No, twist. There you go. All right. Stir that there. All right.
I have this at home. I still don't know how to use it.
Oreo.
The whole thing?
It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's liquid magic.
Wait, can you scoop this in? This, my OCD is gonna fall on your
that
thumb.
That tub of ice cream got a better reaction than any of us have ever gotten on this show.
That's right.
Also, I think that. I've been called a tub of ice cream before.
So now I say we do like a little draft, right? You
Heck
get
yeah.
to pick an ingredient, that's fun.
Yeah.
I get to pick an ingredient, that's fun.
That's right.
And then we blend it and drink.
Oh, good, this isn't planned. Great.
Well, maybe it is, but this is just a fun segment, Tom, and we did pre-plan this. Maybe.
Maybe Pete showed up at 8:30.
You know what? I'm just going right here. I'm going with the bourbon cream.
The bourbon cream. All right. All right. We're staying in the milk family.
Stop swinging that, please.
Shake it up a little bit.
I am going to go with the Woodford Reserve.
Oh. You ready?
To your health.
To your health.
Is this expensive?
It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic.
Yeah.
Oh, that's heaven. All right. Now. Oh, boy. This is going to be fan-friggin-tastic. I'm so excited.
Let's do this.
Pop, lock, come on. Splendid.
I was waiting for him to shake it.
All right. Here we go.
Shake, 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 Sinora, shake your body liner. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sinora,
Spencer, get out
work
of
your
there.
Body liner. Work, 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 Sinora, work it all the time.
My girl's I love name that the blender's not even
I
in
tell
the
you
shop.
I have no
the joke when is at home we don't even have a blender. Oh, there
it's liquid magic.
Look
at
that.
We're good. I can't. We're good. By the way, the timer says we had another 49 seconds of that. That's way too long. Let's just see if it pours.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's see if it pours.
It's liquid magic.
This is going to be so good, I guarantee it. And I'm going to be a disaster.
It's liquid magic.
Oh my goodness.
It's liquid magic.
This is
orbiting Oreos. Oh. That is so good.
I can't actually use this one.
This might be one of the most delicious things we've ever made.
That is so good.
It's liquid magic.
That is.
You only have a whole nother.
That is delicious.
That's phenomenal.
That's right. That's phenomenal. And you can all try some at home for $159.99. It's a new Wigs level.
Wow.
You know. Spencer will drive to your house anywhere in the continental United States.
Whoa, I didn't promise that. What the
heck? Well, I would say another home run. Another.
The key is you have to let him stay over. As long as you offer him lodging, it's fine.
Spencer, we made you a drink. Here you go.
That actually wasn't, okay, honestly, this wasn't that bad. This
Sir, another successful Liquid Magic.
It was.
I hope you all enjoyed it at home, and until next time.
It's Liquid Magic.
I don't know if I'm allowed to be in this car anymore. I don't know at this point. We're going to take a commercial break. We'll be back with more. Stick around.
Hi. You hungry? Looking for a tempting treat? Hold on till I absorb some heat. Some added tang might please you too. I'll slide into an oven fresh bun, and I'm ready for your eating fun.
Why don't you try a juicy good hot dog?
Beach set twists to the big beat sound of the Del Airs, swinging out with six rocking hits. While the cycle gangs burn up the road and strong arm their way into the party with fists flying. While teenagers prepare for a secluded slumber party, terror strikes from the bottom of the sea. An invasion of ghoulish atomic beasts who live off human blood.
Living dead. They're zombies.
Again and again, the fiendish monsters struck like nothing that ever stalked this earth. An entire city in the throes of panic at the mercy of demons from the dead.
Grandchildren of some of the people in this theater will not be born on Earth. They come from the bowels of hell. A transformed race of walking dead. Zombies guided by a master plan for complete domination of the Earth. Plan 9 from outer space. Starring the most frightmarish cast ever. Bela Lugosi, the seductive vampira, and Tor Johnson as the walking dead.
Turn off your electro gun!
off their bodies. Rockets, missiles, jets cannot stop their death ship. What earthly power can stop this terror? For a glimpse of things to come, see this blast of screen suspense. For it could be happening right now.
Welcome back to News Tonight. We're drunk.
Oh, that was great, Tom.
This milkshake is good. It's very good. Oh, you brought the glass over.
Yep.
It's very good. Real quick, we got some super chats, I've been told. So let's check them out if I can read them from here. Let's try
this. I see three of them up on the screen.
Let's see what I'm on board.
Which TV screen Bobbitt, are we supposed to read?
JC Bobbitt wrote, Tom leads a show off with three good jokes in the cold open. We're in for a good one. $4.99.
Nope, those are nope.
Mean.
All right.
It's been 2 weeks since we saw the F word.
It's the guy in the comments. Yeah. No. We'll see.
That. I do remember that. K-Jack, oh. Thank you for... Why do you all support this? Why... Thank you for joining us tonight at BC Fan. Very sweet. Sorry to hear you weren't drafted last Thursday, but there's always your fantasy league. They're just in their own world, those two. Speaking of that, BC Fan, $10 for BC Fan. Here we go. What does that say? These two, K-Jack and BC Fan, ridiculous. It's never going to end. I'm not going to keep reading these.
Just do it. It's time.
Tom is nailing it tonight. Yeah, I just did. Thank you, Amina. Thank you. While we wait to see if Pete makes it in time for Liquid Magic, this super chat is in honor of whoever cut the opening montage sequence. Kungaloosh! From Michael Clark. It was a group. Tyler on his way out did some, and then Joshua, who's taken over, is doing a fantastic job. This is his first week. How about some applause for his first week? We haven't missed a beat, and thanks, of course, to Tyler for making the transition so easy. In honor of Spencer being stateside, Babs behaving badly, sent in $9.99. What is cosmetics? Make Pete dress like a robber again. The Tomorrowland.
Yes.
Trav? Oh, cut off. Yeah. It was $100. Thank you. It's very, very kind, very sweet. It's my catchphrase now. For Pete's aloe.
I'll take that in cash.
You could use the milkshake, maybe. For Pete's aloe facial cream fund. From JC Mom. That might be my favorite super chat of all time. He's just warm. It's Liquid Madness. Another 50. That's too much. Thank you. You're very, very generous. Well, thank you, everyone who super chatted. We appreciate it. And of course, thank you just for tuning in, whoever you are. We appreciate the support each and every week. As you can see, a lot of time and work and effort from a lot of people goes into especially these theme shows. Lucas tonight built a car. And then we have the backdrop from Sci-Fi, and I have the screen over here. I'm taking this home after, by the way. This is going to be in my living room. Everyone thinks I'm joking. I think legitimately it's going in my living room. Everyone did a great job this week, and so it's a lot more. We're only halfway there.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, if you actually watch the show all the time, you know we're less than halfway there. So
another two hours.
We really hit our groove in hour four. Really hit our groove at that point. In order to make it through the rest of the, about another half hour, I'd suggest you take out the one of these you have at home, and, you know, that's how you make it through the rest. Okay, it's time for the Disney Parks Incorrect Fact of the Week. All of the classic cars guests sit in at Sci-Fi Dine-In were purchased from Jay Leno. I had no idea. Yeah, wow. My cars. Now he's a server there. Did you know that? That's a correct fact.
Mm-hmm.
Also, we have to find out what's debuting this week on Broadway. This week on Broadway, catch the toxic, the Toxic Avenger Campus. Oh, I bet it has more than one ride. Ooh, ooh, everyone loves the Avengers Campus. Ooh. You know what you can get for less than the price of a web-slinging device add-on? You can get this great Rebecca the Male Black Swan shirt where all the proceeds go to the Disney Worldwide Conservation Fund. This is just $20, and again, we don't get a cent of it. All the money goes to the Disney Worldwide Conservation Fund in memory of our fine feathered friend, Rebecca. So pick up the shirt. I know some animal keepers at DAC have picked it up, and I know some of our viewers have worn it to DAC, and the animal keepers really appreciated it. So that's great to hear. So please support this great cause. We have a couple left. And then obviously tonight, there's only 100 of these in existence. We, for this show, it almost didn't happen. And Rob Whiteside rushed it and made it happen, or we were not going to have product for the show. I was very sad. And he really came through for us. We have this fantastic Sci-Fi Dine-In, our first button-down, mm-hmm. first Tom Corless shirt. And it's available now. I know it's $75. That is a higher price point than most products. Our margins on them are not good, let me tell you, because we just really wanted to bring them to you. We thought tonight was a special night, and we wanted to make sure everyone who wanted one of these could pick them up. It is modeled after the cast member shirt they wear, a little modified, obviously. We don't want you to blend in too much with the cast members for obvious reasons, but I think it's fun. I'm going to wear this every time That's I go great. To Sci-Fi. I'm excited yeah. about it. Very excited. Another thing we got to plug, the 15th anniversary event for WDW News Today is coming up very soon. Next week, we're going to release way more details, but this is going to happen both at Walt Disney World and as well here at WDWNT Celebration. That is happening July 7th through the 10th. Tickets available now at events.wdwnt.com. And we have very limited space, mind you, because this studio is only so big. And there will be some things that are streamed. And there will be some things that are not. One of the things that will not be streamed is it's going to be Tom Unplugged. We're going to make sure people put their devices away in little bags, seal them up, and we're going to tell some stories that I can't tell on the air. They are... Yeah. No, it's... We've for years, I've said I was never going to tell these stories, and I think at this point, we don't care about Disney, what they think anymore, so we're just going to tell them and see what happens. But only... people in the building are going to get to hear those stories. So, what'd you say?
Or why I was hired.
Why you were hired? We'll tell that story too.
This is discrimination based on location.
We all wish we could be in Japan. Shut up. I would gladly trade places with you right now. Go watch the movie Trading Places. Go watch.
Here, I can host that show.
You can host this show?
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Kid, you can't even make it through an editor shift. You want to host?
You can't even do it.
I'm going to send this. I don't have to. I own the company. I did it for 10 years. Anyway, kids. I swear with these kids. Anyway, what else we got to talk about? Show calendar. See what's coming up. Next week, we're playing the Pyramid on May 19th. We got Card Parks. And another themed show this month, Nick. He just took a big gulp of that alcohol. On May 26th, we are celebrating 5 years of Pandora, the World of Avatar, with a whole show from Pandora. It's going to be, we'll be on the planet.
All blue drinks, Pete.
All blue drinks. Liquid Magic is on that show, in fact. Also, the Shaman of Song is going to be here. The Shaman of Song will be here. A very special show, May 26th. I know a lot of you are in town for the opening of Guardians, so we hope you'll also join us for news tonight here in the studio. And then we are also here on June 2nd. Tickets are available, as always, at wdwnewstonight.com. And Wigs members, you get a discount, or even at some levels, it is completely free for you to attend the show.
Sure is.
Nick, who brings us the show each and every week?
Well, of course, News Tonight is brought to you by The Vacationaire, the engineers of your next magical vacation. Sit back and let their team of vacation planning experts craft your family's next magical Disney trip. Best part is their services are free. Visit WDWNT.travel for details. The Vacation Air, the official travel agency of WDWNT.
Thank you, Nick. Do we have some comments?
Sure.
Walt Disney presents...
The Wonderful World of...
I'm sure the comments are somewhere.
It's good to have them ready for the segment.
Yeah, probably. Oh, it certainly is. And I do.
Don't make me turn this car around.
Sorry, the milkshake making my throat a little phlegmy.
Ugh. Gross.
All right, we're ready. You ready? Is it my time? Oh, it's my time.
They're on the screen already.
Lin-Manuel Miranda claims Imagineers are currently developing an Encanto attraction for Disney Parks.
I hate these Twitter names. Zinu 5. Ew, is this the same as when they sodomized Maelstrom with the Frozen layover?
Jesus.
Lord. Should I not have read that one?
Oh, you sorry. May not want to ride Guardians, sir.
All right. Fair enough.
Oh, Nick, your mic's dead, apparently. Oh, it's the 5-foot woman. Oh, no.
Ah! She's so mean.
I'm not mean.
She's so mean, she threw a microphone at your face. You want to? They read it at home. It's fine. Move on to the next.
That was probably best. They didn't
Why
hear
does your mic always break, like, in the middle of the show?
I asked. They don't tell me. I probably got some milkshake on it. I don't know. At Forceman 4077.
Seven.
Yes, seven. Are there any Imagineers left to develop an Encanto attraction? Good. Fair question.
They're given no gifts to do with
it. Fair question. How about this story? Jungle Cruise boat breaks down, leave guests stuck in darkness at Magic Kingdom. Mm. At Big Business CT, I bet they didn't see that coming.
You sure it wasn't Mandy that sent that one in?
I know, right?
Sounds like a Mandy.
It does, it does. At Kyle J. Morgan, weird. I feel like this ride never used to break down. I mean, it makes sense, sort of like Rise of the Resistance. It'll take some time to finally work out the bugs. I mean, it's not like it's been around for 50 years, or it's relatively unremarkable mechanical parts.
I mean, it's a boat. Things it's happen to boats.
Well, it's a boat. It's a boat.
You know?
Yeah. At Old Salty Goat. Nice. Disney adding some suspense to the ride to give it a more movie-like feel. Mm.
Old Salty Goat is also my favorite salt and straw flavor.
Sure. At What 0080? See that phlegm? Most get to see the backside of water. One group got to see the underside of water. Now these guys got to see the dark side of water.
It is Star Wars week, right?
No. Review, amazing peanut butter cookie swirl cookie returns. Chocolate swirl cookie returns?
I am sure. What?
Yeah, something like
you,
that.
You start with the first word in the name.
Tom, never make me do things I need to read after Liquid Magic. That's
new swirl cookie, new chocolate swirl cookie, new butter chocolate swirl cookie.
Yes.
New peanut butter chocolate swirl cookie.
Anyway, lots of cool things debut at the Gideon's Bakehouse in Disney Springs. At 59, Amber wrote, does this come with a free ride to the ER?
I got my right. needle ready. Right after the cookie. And keep going.
All right, one more story. This one's a good one, Tom. Guests urinate off boat into ride water at Pirates of the Caribbean Disneyland. Mm. At Schwartzy Forever wrote, this is why we can't have nice things like healthcare.
Wow.
At DeMario wrote, it happened a while ago, but they need a clickbait title for a slow news day. Tom.
Wow.
Yeah, them's fighting words. At Logo Lookaway 3, I hope the smell of the water doesn't change.
How do you think it got there?
Yeah, right? At Commander Clark 8. Oh, so that's where the rum's gone. Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Well, if you're saying wow about that one, wait till this one. At Jeff Chers
Are they sure it wasn't Amber Heard? You sure? Want to check on that? Check your facts? Maybe.
That explains why they won't let her in Aquaman. Just pollute the water.
All right, and finally, at JC Bobbitt, they figured if Chapek's been pissing on the parks, they can too. Yeah.
The amazing colossal failure.
Wow.
I can't wait to get a phone call about that tomorrow. Of course, after we post it on Twitter and TikTok and Facebook, it's going on all of them.
That's
it. Gonna ruin the media event. It'll be great. you know what's wild? They brought up Amber Heard.
Mm-hmm.
We went to see World of Color this week, and now, like, it's been years since, like, back when that show debuted, like, Pirates was at its height, right? And so I remember when that debuted, like, Jack Sparrow would come up on the screen and people would cheer and go crazy. And obviously, the years progressed and people kind of, you know, it wasn't that big a deal.
Yeah.
Now that World of Color is back, it's happening again, especially with what's going on in the news. He shows up on the screen and the whole crowd just starts cheering.
Oh.
And I think it's really fun.
Huh.
I really love that. Yeah. I think it's great. But anyway. Yeah. She's just like Allison. She's very mean. All right. We're going to take a commercial break. When we come back, Cornak the Magnificent is here. And as well, we're going to play Who Wants to Win a Lot of Corbucks Hollywood Studios Edition. All this and more. We come back tonight. Stick around after this intermission.
It's refreshment time, and our refreshment stand is loaded with good things to eat. There's crispy, crunchy popcorn, and hot, delicious buttered popcorn, lots of candy, and frosty, refreshing cold drinks. Why not treat yourself at the refreshment center now?
America's missile might.
Mission.
Mobilized against annihilating invaders from outer space.
We have come here to this planet for one purpose only, to acquire breeding stuff to repopulate our planet.
See the kidnapping of the Earth Maidens for the love-starved slaves of the sterile planet.
Very good. We have done well, Nadir.
I am pleased, Princess. You are satisfied.
I will be satisfied when we have enough more like her to commence phase 3.
See the terrifying invasion of the beach party. See a United States astro robot become a creature of death. Earth horror versus space terror. See, Frankenstein meets the space monster in Futurama.
Welcome back to News Tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight is a very special night. We have a great visitor from the East, the famous seer, sage, all-knowing, all-seeing, and project lead for Communicore Hall and Plaza,
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Cornac the Magnificent. Welcome, oh great Cornac.
Why did I get less applause than the ice cream?
You did.
Thank you. Maya. I don't even know what the line is. Whatever. May you get more applause than ice cream. I don't know.
Thank you, Greg Cornac. Now, in my hands, I hold a stack of envelopes that have been hermetically sealed since noon today in a pickle jar at the Tower of Terror. Yes. No one knows the contents of these envelopes but you. In your incredibly divine way, will ascertain the answers without ever before seeing the questions inside these envelopes. Correct, sir?
Indeed.
Anyone can plainly see these envelopes are sealed, so are you ready to divine the answers enclosed within?
Yes, hand Cornac the first envelope, please.
Look at that. All right, Cornac. Don't mind the car there and the snacks. Have a Twizzler, Cornac.
Plan 9 from outer space.
Plan 9 from outer space.
Plan 9 from outer space. What iteration of the Epcot overhaul plans are we on now?
Oh, yes.
Look at the floor. Oh, floor.
There you go.
Catwomen of the moon.
Catwomen of the moon.
Catwomen of the moon. What will season two of Moon Knight be like? Cornac has seen one episode. Cornac has no idea. Have you watched the Moon Knight?
Two episodes.
Oh, two episodes. Has anyone made it more than two episodes? Wow, everyone, we're apparently not keeping up.
No Moonies over there.
But Cornac does appreciate that a lot of people could have went to see Doctor Strange tonight and instead came to News Tonight or stayed home and watched News Tonight. I do appreciate that. And to those of you who are watching after because you went to see Doctor Strange, Cornac knows who you are. And if you think the Scarlet Witch is scary, just wait. Wait till this shows up out of the darkness of your bedroom at 12 at night. And then he'll be out the window, yeah. So. Horror of Party Beach.
Horror of Party Beach.
The horror of Party Beach. Describe the Disney water parks during a holiday in the UK. If it's lower than 70 degrees at the water park, stay away. It's not gonna be good. The giant Gila monster.
The giant Gila monster.
Yeah, we saw that trailer before, yeah. The giant Gila monster. What's your favorite part of the Maharaja jungle trek? That is my favorite part, it's fair.
Yeah.
Frankenstein meets the space monster.
Frankenstein meets the space monster.
Describe the first time Bob Iger and Bob Chapek met. IP good. I leverage IP good.
Oh boy.
Invasion of the Saucer Men.
Oh, Invasion of the Saucer Men.
I thought it was hot in here before. I'm yes. In a robe now in this hat. Oh man, I'm dying in here. We're near the grill. The grill's right back there, making those hamburgers. What would have been a better name for alien swirling saucers? The Invasion of the Saucer Men. Only $15 with Lightning Lane. Mars and Beyond.
Mars and Beyond.
Where does Tony's get its ingredients from? That's their Beyond Burger is really beyond. Like, way beyond. The new menu, what? What about the new Tony's menu? Did you go?
From Uranus.
Oh, it's from Uranus, she said, the yes. New menu. We're going to find out tomorrow. We're going. That's real. Eric, Kayla, myself, we're going to go review Tony's tomorrow at 11:30 a.m. If you don't hear from me by 2:30, send help. They're going to love me there tomorrow. Last envelope?
The last envelope.
You, me, and the 50-foot woman.
You, me, and the 50-foot woman.
Who will not fit on Tron Light Cycle Run?
Cornac the Magnificent, everyone.
I foresee a game.
You do?
That you do. You seem unsure of this, Nick.
No, I do. But for that, I'm a little worried. Has anyone checked on Sabrina? Do we know where she is?
I don't know who that is. She left her microphone. Who would have foresaw that on this show? She's lucky the stall was open. There's like two. Now, someone's been to those restrooms. It's like, yes, they were bad. Very bad. I can't swing the hat, I forgot. Now a game?
Welcome to Who Wants to Win a Lot of Corbucks. Let's get right to our game. Let's meet our first contestant here tonight. Hi, tell everybody what your name is and where you're from.
William from Augusta, Georgia.
All right, well, thanks for being here tonight, William. You ready to win a lot of Corbucks?
Oh, yeah.
All right, let's see how many Corbucks you can win. Let's go for that $1 question here. Here's your first question tonight. Which famous... question. Which famous salad follows the original recipe created by the owner of the Hollywood Brown Derby? You get some choices here. Is it A, I don't eat salad? Is it B, Cobb salad? C, tossed salad? Or D, Waldorf salad?
I think the answer is B.
Is that your final answer?
Yes.
All right, let's say B, Cobb salad. Suspense is killing me. Ooh. Oh, Cobb salad, you got it. All right, you're at that one Corbuck level. Let's go for two. What's your next question here? Which of these Toy Story attractions was opened prior to the construction of Toy Story Land? Was it A, Randy Newman Sing-Along? B, Toy Story Mania? C, Slinky Dog Dash? Or D, Alien Swirling Saucers?
B, Toy Story Mania.
Final answer?
Yes.
All right, B, Toy Story Mania. See? Got it. All right, moving them right along. Let's go for that third Corbuck question here. What is Mickey's final line at the end of Fantasmic? A, some imagination, huh? B, hot dog. C, see you real soon. Or D, good luck getting out of here.
I'm fairly certain it's A, some imagination, huh?
All right, is that your final answer?
That's correct.
Good. All right, let's lock that in. All right, 3 for 3. All right, moving up to that 5 Corbuck level here with your next question. Which road in Disney's Hollywood Studios takes guests to the Tower of Terror?
Is it A, Sunset Boulevard? B, Jabroni Drive? C, Celebration Boulevard? Or D, Rodeo Drive?
I'm a little unsure, but I'm gonna guess A, Sunset Boulevard.
All right, final answer?
Yes.
All right, let's lock that in. A, Sunset Boulevard. You got it, you got it. All right, that next one, your 10 core buck level, that will lock you in at 10 core bucks here. Let's see if you get it. Moving along pretty good so far. Which Star Wars vehicle can you pilot on its namesake attraction in Galaxy's Edge? Is it A, USS Enterprise? B, Millennium Falcon? C, TIE Fighter? Or D, X-Wing?
It's B, Millennium Falcon.
All right, final answer?
Yes.
Yeah, lock that in. I think he's got it. He does. You can't drop below that 10 core buck level. Nice job. Let's go for 15. Stakes getting a little higher here. All right. What is the name of the theater on Sunset Boulevard currently home to Beauty and the Beast live on stage? Is it A, the Backlot Theater? B, Hollywood Hills Amphitheater? C, Theater of the Stars? Or D, Theater Under the Stars?
Can I use 50-50?
You can. Let's remove two of the wrong answers for him. All right, B or C, does that help you out?
Let's go with B, Hollywood Hills Amphitheater.
All right, Hollywood Hills Amphitheater, final answer then?
Yes.
All right, let's lock it in.
No.
Oh, sorry about that. It's Theater of the Stars. But you did get to that 10 core buck level. You'll be going home with 10 core bucks. William,
thank you
for playing.
Thank you.
Who wants to win a lot of core bucks? We'll be right back after this intermission. Thank you, William.
Thank you.
Come on up.
Over there.
Over where?
Over there.
Over here?
No, over there.
Over there.
The warehouse is in danger, the goodies we must save. All officers report at once, the situation's grave. Go get them, boys. What did this say? The culprits must be stopped. We'll make the scene with our siren, Arizona Papa's pop. Aha! The guilty ones are trembling. But the climax isn't kept until we have an intermission.
No! She's a girl who loved a man. A man who, in a flash, became a living threat to humanity. A danger so awe-inspiring that they tried to hide his existence from the world.
Bob Chapek is being promoted at an alarming rate. Now he's in charge of home video, the next day consumer products, the next day parks and resorts, then CEO maybe.
But you've got to stop it.
I don't want to speak in public anymore.
Day and night, scientists search, trying every experiment their brilliant minds can conceive, finding the expected, the unexpected, and the shocking. For the immeasurable power of this ever-growing mammoth portends a fate that terrifies the universe.
Drive it in hard. We have to penetrate the bone in the first ejection. Ready?
Look out, he's reaching down!
We want to help you to get well.
Manning's disappeared, Eric. We can't find him anywhere on the grounds.
The public does not like this man. This is not a news flash.
A man once loved by a woman, now feared by the whole world.
Oh,
60-foot giant in the streets of Las Vegas.
Welcome back to Who Wants to Win a Lot of Corbucks. We have our next contestant with us. And hi, why don't you tell everybody who you are and where you're coming from tonight?
I'm Joe from Kissimmee, Florida.
Joe from Kissimmee. You've been playing a lot of games with us lately.
Yep.
Yeah. You're looking to take some Corbucks from us?
250.
All right. Let's see. Let's start with one, though. How about that? Let's see that first question. All right, here we go. What children's show in the animation courtyard features Mickey, Vampirina, Doc McStuffins, and the Lion Guard? Is it A, Baby Rave? B, Musker Size? C, Disney Junior Dance Party? Or D, Let's Dance with Mickey?
C, Disney Junior Dance Party.
All right, final answer?
Final answer.
Locked in C. Let's see if he gets that one core buck. Got it. All right, for two core bucks. What can be purchased from Dinosaur Gertie along the banks of Echo Lake? Is it A, pins? B, popcorn? C, ice cream? Or D, I love Gertie t-shirts?
C, ice cream, final answer.
All right, let's see, ice cream. Gotta love those t-shirts though, that sounds fun. All right, for three core bucks. What is the name of the boats that travel between Disney's Hollywood Studios and Epcot? Is it A, Friendship Boat? B, Nick's Maxi Boat? Don't laugh. C, Tugboat? D, Ferry Boat?
A, Friendship Boat.
Final answer?
Final answer.
All right, Friendship Boat. Yeah. Nick's Maxi boats have been trying to make inroads in there for a while now. We're trying.
Keep sinking.
Yeah, well, you know. All right, let's go for five core bucks. What colors of milk can you purchase at the milk stand in Black Spire Outpost? A, blue and green. B, black and white. C, rum and tequila. D, pink and teal.
A, blue and green, final answer.
All right, A, blue and green. All right, I know this is post-liquid magic, but I'm pretty sure rum and tequila are not colors. Pete, are rum and tequila colors? Pete's gone? All right, well, yeah, Pete's gone. All right, for 10 core bucks, here we go. What attraction currently resides in the Chinese Theater at Disney's Hollywood Studios? A, Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. B, Don't Phone Tom on This. C, Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind. Or D, The Great Movie Ride.
A, Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway.
All right, let's see if you got this one today. I wonder what was happening to Phone Tom. Alright. So you're locked in at 10 core bucks. Let's go for 15. Here we go. New York was represented on the former streets of America along with which other city? A, San Francisco. B, Los Angeles.
C, Chicago, or D, New Orleans?
I'm using my 50-50.
All right, let's remove two wrong answers. Well, hope that helps you out a little bit. San Francisco or Los Angeles?
B, Los Angeles.
All right, D, Los Angeles. Final answer?
Yes.
All right, lock that in. Oh, sorry, it's San Francisco. But you walk away with 10 core bucks.
I didn't lose this time.
Didn't lose.
I didn't lose.
Thanks for joining us. We'll be right back after this intermission.
It is.
I can't believe that. So I guess, yeah, I didn't even have the script ready. I didn't know we were going to end that quick.
He was going for 250, I know.
Are you okay back there?
I've just, it's been a very long show. I was on the trip of a lifetime, time. I just really just wanted a burger, and I didn't get a burger. Instead, I got sent through a desert, and a mountain range.
Sabrina, the show's over.
One should never be late while having dinner with friends.
Oh! Okay. And it's the dumbest show. The dumbest show. There's a post-show if you haven't had enough of this, by the way. If you want more, there's a post-show if you're a Wigs member. And remember, kids, especially Sabrina, carbon monoxide is a deadly poison. Good night.
Well, I saw the thing coming out of the sky. It had a one long horn and one big eye. Like a Mr. Shaking in the city. It looks like a purple people eater to me. It was a one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
One-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
A one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater. Sure looks strange to me.
One-eyed.
Well, he came down to earth and he lit in a tree. I said, Mr. Purple People Eater, don't eat me. I heard him say in a voice so gruff,
I wouldn't eat you 'cause you're so tough.